PSLE 2021 Math Paper. In this practical math video, we are going to look at the PSLE 2021 Math Paper book question that made some primary 6 children really confused. Now let's read this big book, small book question together and see whether you feel the same way, okay? A bookshelf can fit either 30 big books or 45 small books. There are 3 big books and 23 small books on the bookshelf. What is the maximum number of big books that can be added to the bookshelf? Now, whenever you see a problem, they were forced to fit either one thing or another. For example, we can either fit adults or children on the bus. Or in the case of this PSLE 2021 math question, we can either fit big books or small books on the shelf. We can make use of a ratio to help us see the relationship between the two things, okay? So let me show you what I mean. Since we know that the bookshelf can either fit 30 big books or 45 small books, let's write the ratio of the number of big books to the number of small books that we can put on the shelf, alright? So here we have big books is to small books, 30 is to 45. Do you get that? Now let's see what we can tell from this ratio, okay? Looking at this ratio, 30 is to 45, we can tell that 30 big books are going to take up the same amount of space as 45 small books. And this is going to be super useful to us later on. Let's simplify this ratio so that it's easier to work with, alright? To simplify the ratio 30 is to 45, we are going to think of a number that we can divide each number by without leaving any remainder. Now looking at the 0 and the 5 here, it shouldn't be too hard to tell that we can divide both these numbers by 5, correct? 30 divided by 5 gives us 6, and 45 divided by 5 gives us 9. Great. Now looking at this ratio, it looks like we can simplify this further. And how do we know that? Well, that's because we can divide 6 and 9 by 3. Correct? So let's do that. What do you get when you divide 6 by 3? Do you get 2? If you did, well done. And when we divide 9 by 3, we are going to get 3. Great job, everyone. Now looking at this ratio, let's think about what we can tell again, okay? So this time round, we can tell that every 2 big books is going to take up the same amount of space as 3 small books. So far so good. Now let's go back to the problem and see what we have. We are given that there are already 3 big books and 23 small books on the shelf, and we are supposed to find the most number of big books that can be added onto the shelf. So let's think about how we can do that, okay? The easiest way to do that, my dear friends, is to change all the small books into big books. Once we do that, we only need to look at one type of books. And this is going to make our problem less confusing. Now, if we can change all the small books into big books, we are going to be able to tell how much space this small book is going to take on the shelf. And then we can use that to calculate how much extra space we have to put more big books, okay? Now looking at the numbers 3 and 23, I'm guessing that most of you will get stuck here, right? It's quite difficult to change 3 into 23. But does that mean we are going to give up? Of course not, right? Although it's hard to change 3 into 23, it's not really impossible to do that. All we need is a little patience. So let's do this together, okay? Now, we want to get from 3 to 23, right? It's not easy to get from 3 to 23, but it's going to be quite easy to get from 3 to 1, right? So let's change this into 1 first by dividing 3 by 3. And when we do that, we also need to divide these 2 over here by 3 so that the ratio stays the same. So far so good. Now after doing that, let's think about how to change this 1 into 23, okay? And I'm sure all of you know what to do. Do you think of multiplying 1 by 23? If you thought of that, great job. And that's exactly what we are going to do. When we multiply 1 by 23, we are going to get 23 over here. And don't forget that when we do that, we are going to multiply the other side by 23 also. Okay? So what do we get when we multiply 2/3 by 23? Do you get 46 over 3? I hope you got that. Now, I know that this might look a little bit strange to some of you, but don't panic when you see this. Okay? We are on the right track. Now let's change this improper fraction into something that's easier to work with. When we divide 43 by 3, we are going to get 15 and 1/3. Do you get that? Let's look at this ratio and think about what it means. The ratio of the big books to the small books is 15 and 1 third is to 23. So what this means is that 23 small books is going to take up the same amount of space as 15 and 1 third big books. Following so far? Alright, so what do we know so far? We know that the bookshelf already has 3 big books and 23 small books, right? And if we were to change these 23 small books into big books, it's going to take up the same amount of space as 15 and 1 third big books, right? So in total, the amount of space that's taken by the books on the shelf is going to be 3 plus 15 and 1 third, 18 and 1 third big books, right? Now what should we do to this 1 third of a book? This looks a little bit weird, right? And there's no such thing as tearing out the pages of the books and making 1 third of a book. When we think about the amount of space it takes, we need some space that can fit 1 third of a book, right? So instead of thinking about the amount of space that's taken up by 1 third of a book, we are going to round this number up to 19, okay? And now we know that the books that are already on the shelf is going to take up the space of 19 big books. Following so far? Now what does this mean? How many more big books can we put on the bookshelf? Well, we are given at the start of the problem that the shelf can fit 30 big books, correct? So let's subtract the space that's already taken up by all the books on the shelf from 30, okay? 30 minus 19 equals to 11. You get that? And that's our answer to this PSLE 2021 math question. The most number of big books that can be added to the bookshelf is 11 big books. Now that you've seen how to solve this PSLE 2021 math question, do you find this PSLE math question easy or hard? Let us know in the comments below, alright? Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you soon!